Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for January 8th of 2022, well, it is titled Quadrantids of the North. So what do we see here? Well, this is actually a part of a meteor shower, and the meteor shower is called the Quadrantids. Now, as you may recall, meteor showers are named after the constellation in which they appear to radiate. So if we look here, all these stars seem to radiate back towards a certain part of the sky. You can see each meteor heading back from a certain part of the sky up towards the upper right hand side. Now, it's actually the constellation known as Quadrans Mirales. Now, if you've never heard of that constellation, it's not necessarily a surprise. It would be considered an obsolete constellation. So once the constellations were formalized about 100 years ago, each part of the sky was made part of one of 88 constellations. And those are the constellations that we use today. This is one of the old ones, and one that no longer is considered a constellation any longer. You can see what part of the sky it's in. It happens to be located relatively close to Ursa Major, which includes the Big Dipper. The Big Dipper itself is not a constellation, but is an asterism. An asterism is a prominent grouping of stars, which is not a constellation. Now, it can be within a constellation, such as the Big Dipper, or it can go across multiple constellations, such as the Summer Triangle, which contains three bright stars in three different constellations. So here we see those, and you can in fact see some of those streaks going right through the Big Dipper. They are almost centered in the image towards the top there, looking a little upside down with the bowl of it being emptied out at this point, this positioning in the sky. So this is again a meteor shower which peaked on January the 4th. So we had a number of meteors visible in it from the observing station. We see a bunch of radio telescopes from a Chinese observing station that are in the foreground. Now, one of the interesting thing about the Quadrantid meteors is that they do not come from a comet. In fact, it's thought that they come from an asteroid, which is very unusual. Most of the material we see as shooting stars or meteors tend to be traced back to various comets that the Earth's orbit happens to intersect. In this case, it seems to be an asteroid, and the asteroid must have had some kind of activity. Something happened to it that caused material to be pushed off of its surface, and it's little bits of that material that we see today. So it's unusual in that an asteroid is normally a little more stable and does not change, whereas comets tend to vaporize and lose a lot of material when they pass close to the sun. So while most meteor showers are associated with comets, this one, the Quadrantids, appears to be associated with an asteroid. So that was our picture of the day for January 8th of 2022. It was titled Quadrantids of the North. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be a shrinking red spot. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone. And I will see you in class.